Hi, so
Hi,
sorry for the technical
Lisa.
difficulties.
No worries.
Okay, just correct me if I'm wrong. I'm probably mispronouncing your name. Why don't you just tell everyone how to pronounce your name correctly and then who you are and what you do?
Sure. I'm Mary Shen Venzon. I am a student at NYU School of Medicine. I'm currently getting my MD degree as well as a PhD in immunology. And I'm also one of the founders of PPE2NYC.
Thank you for setting this up. And how'd you decide to set it up? And what is your goal here? And how many people have you helped so far? What are some statistics that you have?
Sure, that's a loaded question, but PPE2NYC is basically trying to get at New York City's PPE shortage from the grassroots. And we do this with by two main ways. The first is just trying to make donations of PPE for the average New Yorker as easy as possible. We are able to do that by teaming up with medical students from all over New York, creating a coalition of students, and then having a single centralized website, PPE2NYC.com, where you can direct New Yorkers and they can donate through a number of ways. The first is through just drop-off centers. They can look and see for any drop-off locations in their area using the map that we have on our website. They could also register their PPE through the form on our website, and then someone from our team or even a resident on the front lines in their geographic area will come and pick up their PPE. The second way that we also try and get at this PPE shortage is through our hotline, and this is where we really are unique in our quest to help with the shortage. And we have this hotline that any frontline worker in New York City can text, and one of the three students that's always on the hotline will immediately connect them with donations in their area or donations that we've collected earlier in that week that we can then drop off for them.
Okay. And in terms of statistics, how many have you collected so far for PPE, and are you expecting more?
As Calvin had alluded to, we don't just collect masks because more than masks are needed for these frontline heroes. We also collect surgical gowns, surgical masks, those chemical gowns that he talked about that help them to not have to change all the time, and also face shields. Currently, we've had over 200 hotline calls where we donated over 10,000 N95s, over 200,000 surgical masks, 300 sterile gowns, and about 205 face shields that actually people are making at home and sending us. Because you can 3D print them, you can use materials from your local hardware store. And so we're getting a lot of donations from people on the ground.
Got it. And you just want to open up for the audience. If you have questions for Mary Shen, just feel free to ask a question now formally. And I again put it up on the screen. But the last question that I have is there are a lot of different organizations that are offering PPE, masks, and so forth. And have you had the opportunity to work with some of them to not reinvent the wheel, but just to, collaborate and just make sure that the sole goal is we get the PPE and masks in front of the medical frontline units?
Exactly. I think all of us are working towards the same goal of trying to get PPE to where we need it as fast as possible. And so, any way that we can connect with people that we see on Instagram with similar missions, we do that. One example is A Million Masks. Shout out to Ben, that's coming up next. And we actually were in a call with his team yesterday. They're getting a huge shipment of N95s, and we're strategizing with them how to donate to over 15 hospitals this coming week. We got a lot of attention this past Wednesday when we did kind of a donation decathlon, where we donated to 10 hospitals over 3,000 N95s in 4 hours, and actually Instagrammed live posted each donation. And so we've gotten a lot of attention from other GoFundMes that have masks and need help to distribute, and they can tap into our system and pipeline to get them out to where New York needs it the most.
Thank you so much for the work you do. So, I wanted to open it up for questions right now to the audience. Okay, the first one's from Alan Lee. To what degree are you accepting homemade equipment, and are hospitals accepting these?
So I kind of talked about this. We are accepting face shields. So if you DM us, we can send you the dimensions that, you know, John Hopkins recommends, and that's what we've been sending out. We don't accept homemade masks at the moment, but we do direct people to Masks for Medicine. They're accepting homemade masks, and they're another team that we've collaborated with and are open to help them distribute in New York as well. So there's definitely people who are collecting those things, and if you can make it, definitely do it.
Okay. And then last question from the audience. How might this impact you and classmates as med students?
So most of our volunteer work supporting the frontline is medical students at this point. We're not allowed to go to school or go to lab if you're a PhD student. And so I think we're all pulling together and seeing how best we can support the frontline, whether it's through reading the latest research and publishing that on Twitter or collecting PPE. So it's actually made a significant impact in the short term. In the long term, I know some of my classmates that have gotten their MD degrees are graduating early, and they're going to work in the hospitals to try and lighten the line workers. And so there's definitely changes that are being made really rapidly. And being a med student right now, there's so many opportunities to help out any way we can.
Okay, thank you so much, Marishan, again for your time. Sorry for the technical difficulties before.
Oh, no
so
worries.
Now we can so now we can move on to Mr. Ben from A Million Math. Thank you.
See ya. Bye, Lisa.
Bye.
Bye, everyone. Donate PPE.